Upland's farm rests on 97 acres of rustic land in Cold Spring Harbor, New York. The farm is home to a 12-acre research station operated by nearby Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory, as well as a large nature preserve. Inside one of these nondescript buildings, two state-of-the-art growth chambers host some of the most advanced climate control technology ever developed for plant research.
So we have two chambers, Mendel and McClintock, that allows us to simulate how plants are going to behave when the climate is changing. We can actually simulate those conditions, for example, changes in temperature. The plants my lab works on are sensitive to temperature changes, so we can actually look at it and in combination with different light conditions.
There are 12 columns of lights, and you can adjust all four different light frequencies per each light column. So if you want half the room to be blue light and half the room to be red light, you can adjust that. Or if you want different combinations of white, blue, red, and far red light, you can adjust those all to whatever specifications you're studying. So even though we're in New York, we're able to grow crops that might grow optimally in somewhere in Asia or Africa or South America, and we can grow them at the ideal temperatures for what they're used to.
We can have recipes for optimal growth because plants don't need all the spectrum. They mostly use red and blue light for photosynthesis, and everything else they get from the sun is basically reflected or goes to waste. So basically you can develop industrial recipes, light recipes, temperature, humidity recipes. You can alter certain parameters. We know that light of the environment has a big influence how, for example, a salad tastes, right? So we could alter those parameters. So we can say, this plant produced in 2023 is so much, but in 5 years, this plant is going to look like this. We can test now, not wait for 5 years.
As climate change threatens plant habitats across the globe, these growth chambers can help scientists future-proof plants against extreme weather events and temperature changes. Genetically engineering plants to withstand these conditions could help strengthen the world's food supplies. Meanwhile, these growth chambers can help point the way toward more sustainable farming practices that result in less pollution. A win-win for science and society.